Welcome to the National Poultry Technology Center video education series. At the NPTC, we strive to keep you informed on all aspects of poultry housing technology. The following short video is intended to help you be more successful and improve your bottom line. We hope you find it informative.
Hi, I'm Dennis Brothers with the National Poultry Technology Center. Every poultry grower knows the importance of the backup generator system. Proper maintenance always has been and always will be the key to a successful backup system. In today's video, we'll be discussing a few key areas that deserve special attention. At one time or another, all of these issues have caused system failures and resulting in lost birds. We want to help you avoid those problems. So let's get started.
Modern poultry housing facilities almost always have an automatic backup generator system. These systems are often computer controlled and highly technical. They require close monitoring and proper maintenance. The most common problems we hear of are usually fuel related, the main one being stopped up fuel filters. This can be caused by any number of things, and it never happens at a convenient time. That's why it's always important to have multiple spare replacement filters on hand. You never know when you're going to need them. Moisture in our fuel systems can cause multiple problems. The fuel storage tank is almost always the source of this problem. Here, a professional generator serviceman is using moisture indicating paste on the end of a dipstick to check the bottom of this tank for water. Note the color change of the paste when in contact with water. No color change on the end of our stick. This tank is okay. The next problem area we're going to look at is intake and exhaust loopers on the generator shed. Unlike the ones we see here, your louvers should always be free and clear of any obstruction to airflow. Do you have to prop open your louvers to ensure they're allowing enough air through? It's a common problem we see far too often. We at the NPTC recommend replacing those problematic louvers with an opening covered with poultry netting or hardware cloth. Opening size is also important to note. Exhaust opening should be slightly larger than the radiator with the generator placed closely to that opening, as seen here. The intake opening should be at least 1.5 times the size of the exhaust opening. Last but not least, let's talk about manual override start switches on your generator. The switch you see here works much like the switch on your tractor. With this switch, you're able to start your generator even if the electronics in the transfer switch or generator itself have been damaged by lightning or are otherwise malfunctioning. These switches are an add-on accessory that may not have come with your generator. However, like the one we see here, you can almost always add them later. Contact your local generator service professional to help you add this switch. Having the ability to crank your generator after lightning has damaged the electronics or the starter mechanism can be the lifesaver to the birds in your house. Thank you for watching this educational video. We hope you found it informative and helpful. To find out more information and learn more about the National Poultry Technology Center, or if you have an idea for our next video, please log on to www.poultryhouse.com. Thank you.